On July 27th, Baher Nebahin and his family were at home when Israeli soldiers started bulldozing it. There's nothing left of it now. The war was raging all around. As they fled, the family was shot at in violation of international law. Baher was captured and taken to Israel.
They didn't have enough information. They needed more. They were asking me about Hamas, the location of tunnels and rocket launchers. They wanted to know who in this area was from Hamas or Islamic Jihad, who was in charge.
Baha' lives in Jorh el-Dik, a farming village on the edge of Gaza. Six Israeli soldiers were wounded here during battles with Hamas fighters.
One of the main objectives of the Israeli army was to discover the network of tunnels that leads into Israel. But many here believe that the soldiers shelled and destroyed their livelihoods indiscriminately. Even this little cemetery wasn't spared.
The destruction stretches all along the eastern flank of Gaza. Trees uprooted, farmland ruined, factories and businesses destroyed.
They destroyed everything. They want us to leave this place, but we're going to come back and rebuild once again.
An estimated 500,000 people are now homeless. Rami Al-Surani says an unprecedented amount of firepower was unleashed on Gaza.
This is totally deliberate, intentional, and they wanted to inflict real pain, terror, and death in the hearts and minds of the Palestinian civilians. No reason can justify what Israel did here. This is a real and strong example for war crimes.
Human rights groups have called for an investigation into alleged war crimes by both sides, and the UN has named a panel to look into the matter. But for Gazans now living amongst the rubble, and for whom the smell of unburied bodies hangs in the air, an investigation may not be enough to bring an end to their suffering and pain. Hoda Abdelhamid, Al Jazeera, Gaza.